QuadJacks TV, and I'm very pleased to be sitting down once again with Bernard Lee. How's it going, Mr. Lee?
I'm well.
The host of Too Many Things to Mention. We were just talking about this earlier. Tell us about your work besides playing poker.
Well, just fortunate. You know, obviously we do a lot of work with ESPN, ESPN.com, writing, and then Inside Deal. But we were very fortunate this year, our fifth anniversary for a radio show, Bernard Lee Poker Show. And we brought it to TV, so it was on Comcast Sportsnet in New England and DirecTV. And if people didn't get a chance to see it, you can go on my YouTube page. We put them all up on there, so it's Bernard Lee Poker. And we were fortunate to interview Chris Moneymaker, Dennis Phillips, and Phil Hellmuth. And mm-hmm. It was a real nice way to bring another medium for the Bernard Lee Poker Show, because obviously we do radio. We're on in Boston, Money Matters Radio Network. And then we do it via podcast, and now we're like, what other medium? So we brought it to TV, and it was really received well, and we're really pleased about it.
You're at the pinnacle of poker media. You really are.
Wow, I appreciate that.
In the feudalism of poker media, I am a serf, and you're just up there.
Far from. I've been very fortunate. You know, it started with writing with the Boston Herald, which I've been still doing for like 7 years, and then ESPN, and I write for Card Player, and you know, it's just been very, very fortunate. I'm very honored to have the opportunities that I have, and also to be able to play professional poker, and you know, it's great.
And speaking of playing professional poker, that's what you're doing right now. You're in the 1500 no limit hold'em.
Yep.
Tell us a little about how that's going.
So it was a great day yesterday. I mean, ironically, I didn't even play many hands, but it just all worked out pretty well. I made a pretty tough call late in the day with second pair, and ended up being the person was bluffing, so I took about a 60K pot, and the end of the day, like fifth in chips, about 105. They started pretty slowly, bubble burst right away, but didn't really matter, and then took a little bit of a hit, ace-jack versus someone, don't know what they have, obviously, flop was jack-high, end up getting it all in on the turn, and person had queens. So I took a little bit of a hit, I went down to about 50,000, half my stack was gone. I'm right now around 41-42. And you know, one of the things that a lot of people, I see this from a lot of people, and I will say, I've been victim of this as well, is that when you have such a nice stack and you are looking really good, you get depressed, right? You're like, oh, I just took this hit. Yeah. And as many people say, like, you try to get it out of your head, you can't. And then I see a lot of people right now about this, they just blow up. And they just, you know, you still have so many chips, and then they just blow up. And one of the things I've done from the beginning, I used to write down literally every hand I played. And I would write down all the comments, and I had a book about this thing. Now I don't do that because it's just too much. But what I do is I write down what chip stacks I have at the certain levels. And I keep them. And as crazy as it is, I actually have kept them. And so this
That's
is
pretty cool.
One of them I had last year where I got really deep in the event. I think I got like 70th or something like that. And if you look at those chip stacks down at level like 16 and 17, I don't have even over 40,000 chips, whereas now I'm over 40,000 chips. So yeah, I'm bummed that I took a hit, but I have more chips now than I did last year when I got deep in an event. And you know, I mean, 70th isn't what we want, but it just, to me, I'm very pleased with it. So when I look at the sheet, it might seem like that's ridiculous. Okay, fine. So it's ridiculous for other people, but to me, I'm very relaxed. I'm feeling very good about it, and you know, just going in on break and say, listen, just keep moving. There's four people at my table have less chips than I do. There's two or three big stacks, but that's obviously an opportunity to double through them. So, you know, I feel good, and hopefully, you know, I haven't taken one hit throughout this whole tournament until this one. So you go 11, 12, 13 hours without a hit, that's pretty good. So I'm pretty pleased about it, and, you know, hopefully a couple double ups will get right back in it.
I don't think you're ridiculous, Bernard. I like you. I think you're cool.
Well, I appreciate that, Mark. Listen, I like you guys.
Thanks. Now, listen, I know you're on break. You're probably going to get yourself a little snack. So thanks so much for talking to us. Good luck.
Well,
you know?
Yep,
and
you.
We can catch up again later. You can tell us more
about it. I just want to say you guys are doing a great job. You had a couple of really nice interviews at the beginning. Nice one with Ty. I think it was good. Nice one with Seth. And everything with the controversy and all that was good to see it right, you know, hear about it right away and get that. So
thank you, Bernard.
You know, it's good
if ever you get swept up in a controversy, make sure to let us be the first to hear about it, okay?
Well, I think I'll do it on my networks first.
All right.
Fair enough. Maybe I'll give ESPN and my radio show the first crack, but we'll definitely
don't you try it.
Okay,
thanks so much, Bernard Lee. QuadJacks TV.